All right, I'll try a happy video. Let's try happiness over this property market. Okay, now, darn Washington, darn for Washington. It's having so many foreclosures that, is that a bad place to go? I don't know, it's really over foreclosured. So I'm like, well, it looks like that's not affordable in a weird, odd way, just because of so many foreclosures. It just seems like a problem. So I kind of, as much as I was going that direction, I'm thinking maybe it's just not healthy. It's not a healthy state. So then I'm like, well, okay, so I immediately turn and redirect back. And I look at New Mexico and I'm like, oh gosh, you know, there are Maine people in New Mexico. I was actually brought into a lawsuit there, and where I'm not the lawsuit type, and I'm like, well, yeah, they're really mean people. I already got a refund wanter back from a book. I mean, they're mean people. Maybe there's just something in New Mexico that makes them mean. Okay, so no, I don't want to go there. Even if it was Taos, even if it was, they had some in Taos apparently that was affordable. Okay, but no, maybe they're just mean people. All right, maybe it's just something in the air. Makes people really fight. So no, I didn't like it. I didn't like that rehab return into it. Because it was exactly like that. You know, it's just like some old grouchy human. It's like maybe New Mexico makes a bunch of old grouchies. Okay, so then I'm like, well, okay, other places. So I look at the cuteness of Utah, and all cuteness of Utah is again, I don't know, it's just too expensive. I did look at that cute website, countrylife.com, and they have houses under 50,000, but they're all on the east side of the America. Okay, they have cute houses for sale, and they're craftsmen or whatever. They're just adorable. Some of them are adorable. So they do exist. So that was a sweet look at. It kind of gave me a relief, you know, because I'm like, well, I'm just about to kill myself, you know, over the situation. Nobody has any plan. Nobody seems to have a plan. So I luckily that site showed up, and luckily it was there, and so luckily there is the East. Luckily, there is the South, you know, so you don't have to kill yourself. There are still houses under $50,000. You don't have to kill yourself. So now I'm like, well, yeah, so I'm kind of bummed out at cutesy Washington, because I believe their prices are just way too high for what's going on. In this tech environment world. Okay, so I really loved Oregon. I love Oregon. You know, I love the coastal cities. They look inexpensive at first, but then they're not, because you have to pay the property tax, and then you start looking at it and you're like, well, no, it's not really that inexpensive in Oregon after all. So you have to like look out in the boonies somewhere, and hopefully it's a place that hasn't been devastated by lumber, you know, past Klamath Falls or whatever. So no, I'm not really that excited with Oregon any longer. So I'm just still, so I, that luckily that site exists. Yeah, don't kill yourself. What was it? It was, under $50,000. They have houses under $50,000. Now they list them. They're in terrible places, maybe, for the coastal decadent livers. We're in Kansas. We're looking at Nebraska. We're looking at, I'm not ever looking at Texas, ever, because of property taxes being triple of what they should be. Okay, looking at, and I'm not really looking at New Mexico because of that decadent grump that lives there. Looking at other places, there's Oklahoma. There's South Dakota, North Dakota. There's, oh no, there's no Idaho listed. Very cold state. No, it's not listed as a possible. And yeah, and Utah did have a very, very few, but they're kind of like those ones that are foreclosures or something. So they're in like Cedar City, and they're something under a place called homepaths.com, HOMEPATHS.com. And I don't know, maybe somebody killed somebody in the house, why it's so cheap, but those ones have a lot of cheapos. So homepaths.com. Okay, and then there's another one. So we keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. You know, this new world. Because I'm always on the press. What is it? I'm on the diving board of the new way to make money. You know, it's just where I live is on that diving board. Oh, I'm so bummed out. I'm so bummed out. Because here I am, like I'm writing the books. I know that's not a new way at all, but I'm writing these books, and I had like a thousand. Not videos, 1,000 images from France and from Ireland, but they were my images of plants and nature. They weren't the dogs, they weren't the ducks, they weren't any people. They were just my nature shots. I had so many nature shots, you know, just, you know, and they're mine, you know, they're mine. So they're my Thoreau moment. And so I've seemingly lost them, and they're on one of these little, what do we call these? One of these? Yeah, they're on one of these, but the disk won't access properly. The USB won't access properly. I'm not getting the name on it, and so that just threw me into a state of tears because I need those images. You know, that's years and years of my work. You know, years and years of my photography. You know, everything. I had them all, like, you know, and these are my red plants, and these are my yellow plants, and these are my green plants, and these are my. I had everything lined up. My yellow flowers, my blue flowers. I had everything in there. So I'm like a little like, okay, I know that USB can possibly work again. I've looked at it. Maybe solder it. I don't know. I've looked into everything, but it's enough to just another. You know. Try not to kill yourself, I suppose, when that happens. But it's really difficult to stay away from emotion because I really need those books. That's for years and years and years of my future was to go back and find in those images. Years and years and years of my financial future. So I'm kind of devastated. So now if I cannot get that back, I'm like, well, then I need a place where I can photograph. I need a place that's filmable. I need a place where I can actually take pictures. Good pictures of nature. And it's not California. I just can't. There's something wrong with the light here. There's something wrong with the light. It's just too harsh. There's something wrong with it. Okay, so I'm like, well, gosh dang it. Where else? Where else? Back to the property. Back to the property, you know, as I'm going that way, going that way, going that way, going that way. Well, gee, you know, it would be nice if I could have this a normal conversation with people, but they don't seem to have normal conversations. And I mean people in the situation that are involved. They just prefer this extravagant ignore of me. Like I've done something wrong. All right, so any hoot. As we go further, I was at Louisiana. So we're looking at Louisiana. Louisiana has many, many houses in that under $50,000 range. So there it is possible in Louisiana. They have areas in Louisiana that are very tall trees, and the other areas that are very plained. So Louisiana is a beautiful state, and so there's property there. Now I'm looking at like little cutesy towns, though. They don't seem to always exist. I saw really cutesy towns in South Carolina. They have that Brevard. They have Montea, and they're right on the ocean, right on the beach. And yeah, so they have cutesy ones, but then I'm like, well, maybe those $40,000 houses aren't there. So I don't know, I'm giving up. So then I'm looking at Georgia, of course. I love Georgia. I've been to Georgia. It's one of the most beautiful states in the world. It's one of the most beautiful places. It's green, it's lush, it's a photographic event for nature. It's beautiful. And I could live there in Georgia, absolutely. So I'm loving Georgia, and I haven't been to Tennessee, but I would appreciate, I don't know, I didn't really like the houses in Tennessee. I was really despondent with what I saw in that under $50,000 range around Memphis. They were not beautiful. It was really like a cheap trip to Vegas, in a way, that kind of look like when you get married really quick. It was one of like those houses are like the marriage drive-ins or something. A lot of those in the South are like the marriage drive-in quickies at Vegas look, or like the funeral home, where you put like, you know, you drive in and there's like the funeral dude and you get to the spot through window. So they're like that. A lot of houses are like that with that carport. But they're under $50,000. You know, so we're looking at Alabama. And Alabama has a problem with the large streets and absolutely gross buildings, oversized, that ruin a downtown, absolutely destroy a downtown. So they have these massive brick buildings, similar to an area. There's an area that's in, they call it Dog Patch in San Francisco. It's similar to that, where they have these mega wide streets and these huge, huge, huge buildings. And they're just extremely non-approachable. They're not for humans, you know, walk around or be. They're not very good inner city areas. Not good downtowns. They don't have any pretty meridians. And that's just the way it goes. So that Alabama is kind of, it may have very, very, very low prices, but it's not pretty. It's not pretty. I don't know. They're like those old Woolworth buildings, and they just left them there or something. So then back to what's next. Don't forget, after as you're going through the South, there's three states there. There's Louisiana, there's Alabama, there's the Georgia, and I am absolutely missing one. Mississippi! Absolutely forgot Mississippi. And so maybe that's a good thing. But maybe it isn't. Maybe Mississippi. M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I is the one, you know, because I can always spell it. You know, if I can always spell Mississippi, maybe that's a good deal. So yeah. So now I'm looking at group purchases. Group purchases. We don't seem to have a website out there. If you want tech people to organize a website, that would be a good one. We need a share group purchase property for very inexpensive houses. And I'm not kidding. I'm talking houses that we can afford, where tech people, where we live normally. And if we have to share three people in a under $50,000 house in the South, then that's the way it goes. And so you would splice the ownership off $15,000 each or whatever. There's no problem with that going on in London. There's no problem with that going on all over England, all over Europe. That's just happens again and again and again. Well, probably not Bulgaria, but it is happening. Probably not cutesy Bulgaria, no. I probably just drove the prices up just then because I said it. You know, I said Bulgaria, so now that $28,000 house is gone. It's gone up to $88,000. Forget it. Oh, I'm just so like, I'm fed up with this system of everything. But yeah, so we have North Carolina also, but North Carolina does have the mountains. Luckily it has the mountains, but in the same token with the mountains, you get the colder weather. You're not going to get that year-round temperate climate. Yeah, and so the house is back to Mississippi. I know we're not beautiful. they were very just not beautiful. So that's what we're dealing with Alabama and Mississippi. Not very beautiful houses under $50,000. So I don't know. Yeah, I've been to the Florida. St. Augustine is kind of pretty, but I don't think it's going to be affordable. It has that old, European charm. I'm looking for that, and that's going to be a difficulty. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe, that's it, because this is such a terrible, lonely world, this tech environment, maybe we have to make that type of a website, something, that gets the tech people more organized, seeing as how we're not living lives as normal, regular people. Whatever normal regular is, so yeah, I'm thinking, what is it, like a share ownership, a share purchase, house type of deal, because for some reason family is falling through. Family has fallen through. I don't know what happened to them, but they've fallen through. Anyway, I'll make another video on that one. But yeah, so we need a website to start making a share group purchases. And not just for expensive areas of San Francisco or LA. It has to be really done properly. Like for real people. Not strangers that just all of a sudden have a San Francisco house.